welcome to the Gen Z Show. It's good to connect again. It's been a while since we've seen each other.
I know. Thank you, James and Abby. Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here. Passion is so important. It's not everything, but it's so important because I believe it's a clue. And, you know, regardless of whatever anyone's spiritual beliefs are, I think most of us believe we're here for a reason, that there's a purpose behind it all. And so I just believe that your passion is going to be a clue to your purpose, because I don't believe God's going to give you a purpose in life that you hate, right? So chances are it's going to be something that you enjoy doing.
Taking this concept of passion and how we find our passion, the next part of your tagline is knowing your priorities. How does finding your passion and understanding priorities fit together, and how do they sometimes conflict, or do they conflict in terms of, do priorities inhibit you finding your passion?
Okay, so here's my take on this. So I was saying that, you know, passion is your clue. It's not everything, but it's important because it's just a clue to your purpose. And then of course, purpose we know is what we're designed to do, what we're created to. We all have unique gifts and talents that we've been given that are unique to us, and that will be tied to our purpose. And when you are living on purpose, when you know like what you are called to do, short-term, long-term, right? You know what you're doing when you're in your teens, and then maybe what you're gonna do the next 10 years. But when you're living on purpose, your priorities become crystal clear, meaning it's when you know what you want to accomplish in life, you're not wasting time. You're not just dilly-dallying on social media all day. You're not, you know, kind of meandering through life. You're kind of more on a mission. Like you, and it's because that passion is fueling that, and it's part of your purpose. So it's like, okay, I'm going to get this done. And you can tell the difference. We've all had seasons where, you know, not a lot's happening. And then there's other seasons when it's like, oh, I checked this off my list and I'm excited. I accomplished this goal. So the priorities part is those will become really clear to you when you know your passion and your purpose. But you can't really know your priorities if you don't know your purpose. And you can't really know your purpose if you have no passion. So passion leads to purpose. Purpose will show you what your priorities should be so that you can execute on the things that will get you closer to the goals that you know, and closer to what you're supposed to be working on. But I think that we, especially now more than ever, we need to know that, I'll speak for myself. I'm connected more to someone who's authentic and real than somebody who's perfect. I can't relate to anybody who's perfect. I can't relate to a perfect business person or a perfect mom or a perfect friend. I just can't relate. So I tend to like it when somebody's a little bit more open and, you know, hey, I don't have it all together, and that's okay. But I have a heart to help people. I want to make a difference. And so the story is really just getting clear on going back to your gifts, your strengths. The way I see story is it is truly a gift. And I believe that our story is a gift from God. And there's parts of our story that are positive and great. And then there's parts of our story that maybe we didn't want to experience. Doesn't mean you have to share the detail, but it does mean that, you know, it's probably, there's something there. Well, yes. So Bookbound is an event that I've been doing for 10 years, now 11 years, going on 11, but it's teaching everyone to how to write a book, how to find your story, how to publish a book, how to market a book. So it's really for people that are wanting to take their story and get it out there in a big way and leverage offer status. So with COVID, we stopped doing the live events. We're doing them virtually. And you know what? It works because the content is really solid and we can get it delivered that way. And even if you don't think you want to write a book, what comes out of that experience is just such clarity on who you are, you know, your gifts, your talents. And again, that is your story, is just who you are. So bookboundworkshop.com. We'll be doing another one here in January.
Are you going to do that one in Florida? I know you would do the January one in Florida sometimes, right?
We do. Yeah. We are just doing them virtually at this point. So things change completely. Yeah.
Well, thank you again for being our guest. We really enjoyed it. And to our audience, someone you know really needs to hear this message today. So share, like, and comment on this either on YouTube or on your favorite podcast app. And again, we'll see you next week on the Gen Z Show. Thank you.